Hello and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to do something educational. For this we would need a robot and a brain. First of all, let's look at robot. It's actually a robotic hand. You see there is a fingers over there and it's actually modeled from my hand. And so we have five fingers and these fingers, they are actuated with the wires over there. There is two wires for each finger. And one wire from each finger is connected to the spring and another one is connected to one of the two servos. There is one servo here, one here. These servos, they actuate these two rollers and wires, they pulled by one or another roller. So we have five fingers and only two servos. This means that we cannot control each finger independently. We can control only one finger independently, obviously which one, and the other fingers with another servo. And over here we have Arduino Pro Mini installed. And from the other side it's just a power supply to power up these servos. By the way, the servo is TSD99X. Each finger has three joints, like here. And inside of each finger there is a channel for the wire. And you can see it also over here. And if you open the finger, you see it from the inside. So if we pull one wire, it should open the finger. And the second wire, which is connected to the spring, it puts this finger back to the closed position. And for the brain, I use Jetson Nano. This is a classical Jetson Nano with a 4 GB RAM. I tried to use a Jetson Nano 2 GB, the latest version, but it was not powerful enough, or maybe my program was not optimized enough, so it did not work well. Small Raspberry Pi camera. This is Wi-Fi antenna. And over here I have USB sound card. I also attached the fan. It worked fine without this fan, but it was getting quite hot, so I decided it's safer like this. All 3D printed parts looks ugly because this was 3D printed on my really, really old 3D printer. This 3D printer was good 5 years ago, but not now. And this is the schematics of the entire project. This is Jetson Nano. It connected to the Wi-Fi. It has the sound card and also the camera. And this is our robot. The servos and LEDs, they are controlled by Arduino, and Arduino is controlled by the three wires from the Jetson Nano. One of these wires is ground and another two wires from the GPIO connector. In the Jetson Nano, I enabled VNC and SSH. Like this, through the Wi-Fi, we can communicate with the iPad and we can use VNC viewer and web SSH in order to control and change some stuff on our Jetson. Also, we have the object detection module, which reads the data from the camera. And I used the SSD mobile net model from the Jetson inference, which do the object detection of the person, of the human. And afterwards, we use text-to-speech, Google text-to-speech, with MPG-123 in order to make the sound and play this sound in our speakers. Let's now quickly look through the program. So I use Google text-to-speech. These are the modules which you need for the object detection. Here I initialize all the GPIO pins. This entire part, this is for the text to speech, and when you run this program first time, you need to uncomment this part. Here we initialize everything for the object detection, and this is our main loop where everything is happening. So we capture the image, we do the detection on this image, and if we detect something, we check what we detect. And we look if we have the class ID 1. This is for the human, for the person. Here we check that we did not detect the human 5 seconds ago. It means that if we did not detect 5 seconds ago, it's a new human. So we need to welcome him. And here we do either this welcome part or this welcome part. And that's it. As you saw from the code, this robot is going either to welcome human or to do the opposite. Let's test it. Now I just need to connect by SSH or VNC and run the program. Yeah, okay. Let's now test it on my girlfriend. Can you come in, girlfriend?
Go away, loser. This is not nice.
Try again.
I hate you. Hey, man.
Yeah.
Greetings, human.
Oh, that was much better than at the beginning.
You see. It gets nausea.
And by the way, this is only works with the human. And this is perfect. Like this, it's not gonna say bad words to the robots or animals. Because animals and robots, they are good. Let me show you. I have this. This is going to be our animal. Let's test it. Now let's try to put the animal. No detection. Perfect, you see? So this is animal and robot friendly robot. And if there is a human?
You are a total dick.
You see the difference? So as you can see, this is a perfect robot to welcome people. You can put it somewhere at the entrance, for example, at the entrance of the public building. And when someone is coming in,
fuck you.
It's going to welcome you.
Go away, loser.
Or like this.
Stupid human.
It really does not like me.
Hey, man.
Finally, something positive. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Huge thank you to people who support my channel. Here's their names. These are people from Patreon and channel membership. Good luck with your projects and see you next time.
Go away, loser. God damn it. Another idiot.
Cool.